What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. You may see that you're watching TV, but you're not watching real TV. You're watching Sling TV, and I'm going to give you a review of this because I've been playing around with it for the last few weeks. All right, so I have Gone Girl up on the screen playing. You're actually seeing a shot of my TV. And one of my issues has been that cable, in my case, AT&T UVerse cable, is brutally expensive. And they used to kind of give me 10 bucks off a month for a year, that kind of thing. But last time I called, they were like, no. And so I wanted to try some things to possibly cut the cord. And so I have subscribed for 2 months to Sling TV. And part of that subscription was because they throw in this Roku Express if you prepay 2 months. So obviously I needed a device with the Sling TV app. Now, and let's just go back here to the main screen, okay? And in my case, I'm actually using the Amazon Fire TV Stick, the cheaper one. And it's been great. And if you have Amazon Prime, you're gonna like it. I did a little bit of a review on that, so you can check out that video. So I've got the remote here. Now, I have installed the Sling TV app. You can go to the App Store. The Sling TV app is available on the Rokus, Amazon Fire, Chromecast, I believe, and the latest generation of the Apple TV. In fact, I have an Apple TV, but it's not the 4K version, so you really need Apple TV 4th generation or the 4th generation 4K in order to get to the App Store. I've installed it here, and as you can see, it's right at the corner, so I've got it highlighted. I'm going to open this. And a couple of things that I want to show you. First of all, it looks like it's going right back to where it was because I was already playing something. But what I want to do here is hit this back button to kind of go to this guide. And now you might be able to see right up here at the top, it actually says guide. I actually really like this because it looks and feels like a cable TV guide, right? So your experience is very similar to one you'd have in cable. And so this is gonna be very friendly to people who are, they're embedded in traditional cable television. And so this looks very similar. So let me just go here to BBC, Star Trek, The Next Generation. One of the things that you'll notice is once you go down and you select it with this button here, like you would on cable, instead of it starting to play, you get this information screen, which is fine. And one of the differences is that it says watch, record, and the series. And what I can do is I can hit record here, and just like on my cable box, I can select all episodes, new episodes, or this episode or only, which is kind of typical. But as opposed to it auto-playing, you're gonna have to select the watch button. Now it's gonna play here, and this, I was just watching this episode, Suddenly Human, and this was kind of in low def, but you can see it's actually high def because the logos and things like that are in high def. Now, because the remote, especially on all these devices, is not based on the Sling TV app, one of the things that you miss are kind of like rewind, fast forward, you know, recall buttons. But you can access those, at least on the Amazon Fire, by hitting this menu button. And I think the app is going to look the same on most of everything. But if I pull up this menu, you can see there's a recall button right there. So if I hit that, it's going to return to the last channel I was on. In this case, Gone Girl. So that's pretty nice. And I can pull up this menu with this middle button and get to details, information, turn on closed captioning, go back to the My TV guide station, or record. So if I hit record here, it's just going to start recording, which is kind of cool too. I'll show you the DVR section here in just a little bit. Now, if I go back and I hit the back button to go back to this main screen, I can also, instead of being in this grid section, I can go to channel guide here, like, and it'll show me all the channels. Now, this is probably more efficient. You know, I can kind of sort things. I can look at all the shows on FXX or whatever, TBS here. And so because cord cutting is a little bit more like having everything at your fingertips as opposed to just watching whatever cable is serving up to you at this time, this is probably the better way to search for stuff, but it's just not quite natural enough to me. I actually really don't mind kind of discovering things or watching things that I haven't watched in a long time, like Lara Croft Tomb Raider. Now, I will say also I have not subscribed to a very high package, but I haven't subscribed to the lowest package here. I also subscribe to the $5 a month add-on for DVR, like I said, which I'll show you. But you can see here, even with my 25 megabit per second internet connection, the streaming happens very, very quickly. So I'm really impressed with that, right? And I will also say here, if I go to the details, one of the things that's a little bit lacking here is in these detail and information screens. I want to say actually on cable, they seem to be a little more robust. Like right here, even on Lara Croft Tomb Raider profile, it's got the picture and it looks nice. There isn't any actor list. you know, oftentimes it'll show who it's starring. It'll also show when it's on again, some of that stuff. So it's a little bit more basic, which is absolutely fine. I'll go back here to the main screen. And you also can go to a variety of different tabs up at the top. On Now, My TV, you can set up your favorite channels, which is kind of nice, especially if you want to group things by sports or TV shows or something like that. And then there's obviously a sports channel there, which is going to be a lot of March Madness right now. But most of the time, I'm on this guide channel, so that's pretty cool. Now, I will say, again, the lacking is noticeable on the remotes because this isn't really set up for TV. You know, on my cable remote, I can kind of scroll by page. Here, I've noticed I have to scroll line by line, and it's no big deal, but it is what it is. And the other thing I will say, though, is it's very quick and responsive. It's actually feels actually a little better to scroll on this than it does on some of the iOS devices, which I will show you, because they're, you get momentum, and you kind of get these really fluid scrolling, and sometimes it's hard to stop it without tapping. But on here, it's very much like cable. And actually, in my case, it's much quicker than my cable TV guide, where often I'll go to a page and then it kind of populates all that information as you're doing it. All right. So I also want to show you here, if I go to back up to My TV, we can go down here to recordings. And so here's stuff I've recorded, me and other people in the household. So like here's In the Loop, I guess, and it'll show me some of the details I've recorded, and I'm going to go ahead and click watch, and you can delete from here. And the Sling DVR, I think for the $5, records 50 hours of DVRing, and obviously it's all in the cloud. And that's really one of the cool things is for me, and the improvement over AT&T UVerse, is that I could control my DVR from the UVerse app, but I couldn't watch anything. So I could, you know, if I was on vacation or a business trip, I could schedule to record a show, but I couldn't watch it. And so ironically, when you're on vacation or you're traveling, that's really when you want to crush out a lot of television, you know, those recordings. That's when you actually have a chance to watch some of the recordings that you've been queuing up for months or months and months. So the beautiful thing is on the app, whether it's on the, my case, the iPhone or the iPad, you can watch those wherever you are. And that is a huge, huge benefit because there's no physical device here that's recording it. It's in the cloud. All right. So now on a recording, I can kind of skip ahead here. And as you can see, it's giving me some preview pictures, I think. It's actually kind of like scrubbing in a YouTube video where you get a little screenshot of what it's doing or where what you'll see when you get there. And so that's pretty nice because especially when you're trying to scrub, you know, on cable, it's not really that good. So there's one of my favorite people, Layla Rahimi, and on In the Loop, super talented Chicago sports broadcaster. Okay, so that works very well. And I do want to show you something else. So I want to go back to live TV and show you a little bit of some of the, what I would call, some of the things you might sacrifice. So go back here, load up Lara Croft Tomb Raider. What I will say is that apparently when you stream things, it continues to stream them. So what you might have noticed there is if I kind of use the recall, it jumps back. It doesn't really have to buffer anything, it appears to be. Now, one of the things I want to show you here is that even though that I have a play pause button on the remote, if I hit it here, it on pretty much everything I've ever tried, it says this action is not available, in this case, Independent Film Channel, but whether it's BBC or whatever. So for whatever reason, I'm a little surprised that you can't pause. What I think you end up having to do is you'd have to go here and record it, and that'll kind of start adding it to your DVR, and that will give you some more of the control, like I said, when you go to the DVR and initiate the recording. So that's a little bit of a bummer. You know, I would say that there's a lot of times when people are talking or you want to go grab a drink or some food and you want to pause, you know, the show, you just, for whatever reason, you can't really do that here. Okay. So that's something you'll give up. I also want to kind of talk about, as you might be able to see here, if I scroll through all the channels, there really aren't that many channels. And so you really want to pick the package that has the channels that are important to you. And there is a little bit of difference between the packages between Sling TV and DirecTV Now, which is honestly probably where I'm going to eventually get, particularly because they seem to have a more robust offering of local broadcast TV, which I kind of do watch a lot. But what I found out, and what I guess I was worried about, as opposed to the 200 channels I'm getting with AT&T UVerse, you know, the 40 that I'm getting here on Sling is great. The only one I'm probably missing that I kind of notice is like the Velocity channel, I think is what it's called. But pretty much everything else, I mean, it's just been fine. And in fact, I found myself opening this a lot of times before cable. Something else I'll mention here is that on my cable box, if it keeps running on the same channel, eventually it kind of shuts off. Now, I did turn this on, and if I go to something like, I don't know, Cash Cab here and play it, and if I leave this running and turn off my TV, I came back like a day later and turned on my TV and it was still running. So the Amazon Fire Stick, as well as the Sling app, doesn't really time out, which is kind of nice, but can kind of be bad, I guess, if you minimize it on an app and you're using data. But I'll show you some of the limitations with the app. Some of those surprise me, but we'll get to that too. Sometimes you're watching a show like this, the Hitman 47, I think, and you want to go to the guide without leaving the show. And so you can actually hit back and go kind of back to the menu. But in this case, if I were watching it and didn't want to disrupt it, sometimes you just want to channel surf a little bit and see what else is on. You can actually either do this, you can either hit the up button, and that'll bring up a guide here at the bottom, kind of like the tabs. If I get out of that and hit the down button, this brings up the whole guide so I can kind of surf around and not necessarily leave that show. Now, it's still playing, I can hear it, but I can actually select something else and jump to that, which is pretty clever. And again, I like how quick the stream it picks up. The other thing you can do is hit this menu button. And that'll take you to the main screen, which you can obviously then get to the guide or the other shows like that as well. Then of course, if I jump back to the last channel, somehow it's kind of maintained that stream. So I really like that. So pretty cool. So you can surf the channel guide without leaving the show that you're currently on, technically. Pretty cool. So right off the bat, I think really, really impressive stuff. The one thing I would like is I wish you could auto-load the Sling TV here app when you turn it on, you know, but you can't do that. And that's kind of a bummer because that would almost make it feel even more like cable-ish. So pretty awesome, pretty awesome. Now let's take a look at some of the other ways you can watch Sling. All right, guys, so we took a look at it on TV. I've downloaded the Sling TV app here. We'll go ahead and open that up. So, like I said, I've been really impressed with the Sling TV service so far. I am on Wi-Fi, so keep that in mind. The things will vary a little bit depending on the speed you're getting. Now, here it shows my recordings right away. So let's just open Pawn Stars here, and I can tap watch, and it should be... saying now playing on an external device, and that's because I'm using the screen capture recording software that's built into iOS. So that's one of the things that you can obviously do. Now, if we go back here and I go up to my TV, and let's see, if we look at guide, and again, this is where I was talking about the guide loads pretty quickly. It feels a little bit more like cable. If I go down to something here and scroll down, I can see everything pretty quickly, and I can obviously scroll ahead to the future to find something and hit record. Now, this is one of the things that I found a little bit funny is that because it moves so much and is so fluid with your finger, sometimes it's a little bit confusing because you kind of swipe with a little bit of an angle and kind of swipe into the future. Not a big deal. I like the fact that it's so snappy, but you just got to get used to that. You can watch things here. So if I go to Hitman Agent 47 and I go ahead and tap on that, again, it will take a moment to load, but certainly works, which is pretty cool. And when I go back to a main menu, what you'll see up in the top right corner is that you get a little play icon and where it's playing. So you can kind of quick resume back to that, which is pretty cool. Closed captioning button down on the bottom works. And if you don't have a streaming device with the Sling TV app, you can AirPlay this too. So that's pretty nice.
So I definitely like this app, and it's very similar on the iPad as well.
Okay, now I'm on my iPad and the Sling TV app. I'm gonna open it here, and I just wanna show you one thing about the Sling TV app that I think is a little bit different than what you'd expect on the iPhone. So one of the things that I wanted to bring up here is if I open a video and start watching it here, and I hit my home button, often in these video apps, it will kind of minimize down to the corner. It does not do that on the Sling app. And in fact, what it does is it kind of stops the video too. And so you have to go back and turn it back on. Now you can, and you do have some ability to multitask here. If I pull up like my Safari browser, I can load that. And then I can even kind of force dock it, I believe, here. And so I can be kind of productive and use things when I have the Sling TV app on, surf the web, maybe have the video, but it's very much like using the YouTube app in that the video itself won't kind of float over things, right? So that's a little bit disappointing. I wish it kind of floated up in the corner and was controllable like picture in picture, but at least I have not been able to figure out how to do that yet. So that's one of the drawbacks, but it's a fairly small drawback because I can still watch TV while I'm using either email or a browser. So overall, I'm really impressed with it. The Sling TV service may not be the one I settle on permanently, but you know, combined with the free Roku, you can certainly for a couple months have that experience, get a streaming box that's compatible with the service, and try it out for pretty cheap. So I'm really liking the idea that I'm about to be able to be a cord cutter because I think that's gonna put some money back in my pocket, which then will allow me to buy more candy. Peter Von Panda, out.